Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. As of yesterday, Apple has released the iOS 18.1 beta 4 to every iPhone, such as iPhone XR, iPhone XS, and iPhone 11 to the latest. Okay, so you can go ahead and install it if you are interested. You can get the public beta, which is a free beta. You can download it and you can install it on your device, and then you can see if whether your device is eligible for Apple Intelligence. So this is my iPhone 14 Pro Max. I was able to install it on my device, so we're gonna see what's in this update, so stay tuned. Okay guys, so when I go to settings right now, this is what I got. So I got the developer beta version, which is a paying version, and the public beta is free. So I'm going to show you how to install that in your device so that you can download this software. Usually Apple release a beta to the developer versions, and few days later, 2-3 days later, they released it to public beta. So I'm going to show you how to install that so you can start enjoying the new software. However, you proceed at your own risk, because the beta files may contain some bugs, such as battery drainage and some other bugs. Okay, so let me go here, let me show you on my device. When I go to about, you can see that this is my iPhone 14 Pro Max. Okay, so this is it right here. So let's go back. And now we're going to explore what's in this software. Does it have the Apple Intelligence? We don't know yet, so we're going to find out. Guys, so when I click long press on the power button, I still have regular SIRI, which means that the Apple Intelligence is not available yet for this update. So I'm assuming that since the iPhone 16 is not out yet, they cannot seed the Apple Intelligence in this software. However, I've seen people with iOS, with iPhone 15, they were able to get the Apple Intelligence. They've been testing it, and I heard that the new software, the Apple Intelligence, is not gonna come, it's not gonna be on the new iPhone that's coming out. The new iPhone gonna come up with regular SIRI. However, they're gonna update it to the Apple Intelligence in few weeks. Okay, so now let's see what are the features of this new software. Okay, so one of the new features is that you can rearrange your icons. You can place them anywhere you want. So let's go to icon right here. You can place them anywhere you want. For example, as you can see here, I can move my icons. You know, you can move them left, right, up and down. You can place them anywhere you want. Before, when you move the icon, it goes back to the same position it was before, but now with this update you can move some icons, which is a great feature. You can also schedule a text message to send later. For example, I'm gonna say happy birthday, right? So if I know that my friend's birthday is coming up in 2 days, but I don't want to forget to send him a happy birthday wishes, so in this case I can set up, write happy birthday and then program it to be sent 2 days later. So in that case, you're gonna go, you write whatever you're writing, and then you click on here and you select send later. So I want it to be sent in 2 days, which is September 21st. So you can select the date here. You can go until all the way down to the next year if you wish to. But right here, I'm gonna say, for example, November 4th or October 2nd, it's my friend's birthday. So October 2nd, my friend's birthday, so I'm gonna send it at 9:45, which is a reasonable time to send a birthday wish to somebody. 9:45 a.m. I'm gonna say 9:45 a.m. on October 2nd, right? And then you click on send, and as you can see it here, send later, October 2nd at 9:45. So when time comes, the phone will send a text message to my friend, wish him happy birthday, right? So that's great. It's a great feature, right? So then That's how you do it. And then you close it and that's it. So now I'm gonna delete this because I don't need to send anyone happy birthday. So I'm gonna be deleting it. All you have to do is click here and delete message. And also another feature, guys, happy birthday to my friend, right? You can send animated text message. For example, right here, you can right click, you can long press and select happy birthday. And then you can click on this arrow and you can select text effect. So text effect will allow you to send animated text message, right? You can select explode for happy birthday, ripples, bloom, or big letters, or nod, or anything you wish to, you know. And then you can send that to your friend. You can also bold it, make it bigger, big fonts, italic fonts, or underline, or anything else you want. So this is one of the best feature of this update. And now another great feature, guys, for this update, you can go to flashlight. Actually, let's check out the control center. Right, as you can see, the control center, when you long press here, you can move certain icons to different locations as well. You can move them to wherever you want them to be. And sometimes you can even increase the size of certain icon. You can see it here. You can increase the size. And right here, you can increase this one, right? And also, as you can see, you get extra pages. This is the music page, so you can see the music status as the music plays. And also here you get the connection panel, which is the Wi-Fi, AirDrop, cellular, Bluetooth, and etc. And you can add page if you wish to. Here you can add control. Add control, you can select any of these icons that you wish to add to the new page, which is an amazing feature as well. And now flashlight has nice animation. So as you can see it here, you can select the intensity of the light. You can make it bigger, brighter, or dimmer, or you can slide left and right to make it either wider or more spotty, right? As you can see it here, guys. So this is the flashlight on the iOS 18. And the next great feature, you can customize your home screen. So when I go to customize this, the lock screen, I mean. So when you come here, as you can see here, the icons, the flashlight and the camera icon, you can change them to a different one. All you have to do is just click and delete them. And then now you can go to add. You can add any icon you want. You can select any in this page. I'm just gonna pick a random one, for example, haptic music. And then I go to the next one here. I can select dark mode, right? And then click on done and done. And as you can see, I got new icons on the lock screen. And now the best feature again, guys, is this. We're gonna long press. And here you can go to edit. You can long press anywhere in the home screen and then you can press edit. And from here you can customize. You can customize either the widgets. You can select any widgets you like, or you can go back to edit. You can customize the home screen. So when you hit customize, this is what comes up. You see the icons here. So you can select light icons. That's the way the phone is right now. You can select dark icon, right, which is very nice, or automatic. Automatic means that during the daytime it gives you light icon and nighttime it gives you dark icon. So that's automatic. So this is the dark icon at night and light icons during the daytime. And here you can choose the color of your icon. You can choose any color you want them to be, which is a great feature here. You can choose blue, red, pink, orange, any color you wish. And then you can select the, you can increase the intensity of the icons if you want them lighter or darker. and this is one of the best features. And now we're gonna go back to the lighter color. You can choose larger icon or smaller icon. On this button here, you can select the brightness of your wallpaper. So you can select dark wallpaper or brighter wallpaper. So guys, this is all I got for this update for the new iOS 18.1 beta 4. You can get this update for any iPhone. So let me show you how to get it. You have to do is go to beta.apple.com. So this is the URL, this is where you go to. So you go to beta. So as you can see it here, this is Apple beta software program. You know, you can go ahead and read up and you can select the your device, either iPhone or iPad OS, Mac, Sequoia, TV OS, Watch OS, HomePod software, right? And from here you can sign up. So let's check out the iOS 18 right here first. And here it should give you a rundown of the iOS 18 capability, you know, the beautiful stuff that come with this update, right? And then now let's go back and you go to sign up. So when you sign up, it's gonna ask you your Apple ID and your password. So as soon as you sign in with your Face ID or username and password, it's gonna take you to this web page. And from here, this is where you go and sign up for the beta profile. And then once you get into this page, you can scroll down and you're gonna enroll your device. So when you click enroll on your device, right, so you can open the beta update. But since I already have it, I'm not gonna proceed. But anyway, you have to go to beta.apple.com to enroll your device. So this is it, guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and smash that notification bell for more videos. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.